Well, hello, everybody. Let's draft. Ryan from Mana Bluff here. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for the pre-release this weekend. Hope everyone's really stoked for Born of the Gods. I'm gonna be skipping the Super Bowl in order to go mess around with the pre-release, so that's gonna be super fun. Although I kind of have to wonder what the Wizards thinks when they're doing different scheduling and stuff. I doubt they really care about the rest of the world, but you gotta think that Wizards know their audience of putting pre-releases on Super Bowl weekend and Valentine's Day weekend, because the Modo doesn't arrive until Valentine's Day. And yes, all of us fun dorky kids are gonna peace out of the Super Bowl and peace out on Valentine's Day, and all we have better to do is play Magic, which is actually very true in my life. We take Nelea, Guy of the Hunt. It's a god. I like green. It's fun. And yeah, my there's no black cards here besides return Centaur to four, so there you have it. Followed by not particular awesome. This time defeat is fine to stay on color. Ordeal is probably the most powerful and possibly worth grabbing. And yeah, other than that, I mean, what, Sealock Monster is fine and good, but not amazing. Pretty weak pack overall. Since I have Nylea, Guard of the Hunt, I'm happy just to take a removal spell because I'm planning on going green. And Time to Feed is a good removal spell, so that's pretty fine. Here, wow, another pretty weak pack. Not a lot going on in these packs right now. Took a really nice, strong Mythic Rare, then after that, blah. Feral Invocation, I'd run in green, especially with it wanting like a heavy devotion. But I don't really want to pick it up that early. Same with this Fairy Band Centaurs. Outside of green. I mean, and then there's like, what, a Fate Foretold? We did see the Ordeal earlier, but if we take a Fate Foretold, I might as well just take the Feral Invocation, right? Yeah. And then just a bunch of dorky whatever cards. I love me my Scholar of Athreos, though, but not something to care about in the moment. Alright, here's a late Vaporkin and a late Voyaging Satyr. So, kind of. And we saw a little bit of blue with the Ordeal, not a big deal, but also that Fate Foretold in those weak packs. Satyr for sure is our pick here. I want to stay on the green route, and I do like Satyr much more than Vaporkin, and it's on color. Looking to get a Vulpine Goliath to the table, even though we're pretty low in the packs already and there's not a lot happening. We passed that early Vaporkin from my Nelea, Guide of the Hunt pass, so maybe we're not going to see a lot of blue in the near future, but for now I'm happy to have that. Not going to take the Centaurs here. Might want to take the Divine Verdict, although Titan Strength's also good. Destructive Revelry's fine. We're jumping to another color because I really don't want a Savage Surge since I already have a Time to Feed and a Feral Invocation. I really just want to be seeing better creatures in green. And even though I don't like green white all that much, Divine Verdict is a nice removal spell. And should I end up going like base lots of green and then have a couple of powerful spells in there, that's kind of what I want to do. But then Titan Strength is a pretty nice combat trick as well. We didn't see a lot of red or white otherwise. But I think I'm gonna go ahead with Titan Strength. And maybe get like a nice sort of a red-green beatdown deck started. Wow, what a really weak set of packs. Another Fate Foretold is okay. Hunt the Hunter for the sideboard, but at this point I'll just take a Satyr Hedonist. Maybe ramp if I'm splashing a little bit of red, but it's more just let's get another two drop, get some devotion on. I already have one Feral Invocation, I need another. Blah-dee blah blah. Oh wow. Now this pack must have been stacked. We have a God's Willing, another Titan Strength, and a Train Tactics, all very good cards. I think I like Train Tactics the most out of the three in terms of pairing with green. I like green blue much better than anything else. And we've seen more blue than anything, to be honest. God's Willing is the best card of them all in terms of in a vacuum, not pairing with a color. We did see that Divine Verdict dose picks ago. But then also, I might just want to take another Titan Strength and just go green with some really strong red tricks. Yeah, we'll do that. Why not? Let's have some fun. Zero black cards being seen, although, and of course, now there's a Blood Tithe Harpy. Sealock Monster's pretty good, but I want to go. I still care about this Nylea. I shouldn't force it too hard. It's just kind of hard to read signals when the packs are so weak, but it looks like blue and red are kind of happening. I'll stick to the red plan. I haven't seen anything that makes me want to move away from it necessarily. Maybe I'll take this Battlewise Valor instead of the Fate Foretold. We saw some good white combat tricks late. But yeah, not a whole lot. And a Sealock Monster tabled, we'll grab that now. Fairies Band Centers into 5 is fine over a Hunt the Hunter. We saw two of these in the draft. I don't think we need a whole bunch of them. There's that Volpine Goliath as planned coming back. And then a bunch of dorks. Just a bunch of dorks. So yeah, kind of, well, uneventful. First pack, based on how low the power level is, kind of expect this to happen. I'm not married to red with my two Titan strengths, so if we open any other super strong card, I'm willing to go there, but ideally we just start getting rewarded with some good green, and some more powerful packs. And then having to rest on this Voyaging Satyr as a possible signal in the third pick from the last pack to do good things. Here we open quite a nice pack of lots of delicious things. A rare that's worth some money, great uncommons, decent commons as well. Let me check what Thoughtseize is worth and see if I got a rare drafted. Yeah, sadly I'm gonna have to pick up this Thoughtseize in the first really good pack we saw. It's going for like 5 to 6 tickets right now. Easily at least worth a pack, and that's pretty much my need to grab phase. What I'm hoping to see table is this Nylea's Disciple. It's the main thing I want to turn on Nylea. Although I'd be happy with the emissaries, the ooh, Nemesis Immortals. I'm gonna slam here. There's a nice Wingseed Rider. I would happen with any of those like decent cards, Nimbus Naiad coming back if we end up going into blue. But yeah, Nemesis is by far the slam pick here. Hoping to round out the deck with the Nelly's Disciple. Might get the Sedge Scorpion back because we have a Lightning Strike, which is really good if we were to stay red, but I'm not sure I'm doing that, so I'm not prioritizing that. Wingseed Rider also good. A little bit harder on the mana if we're trying to go major green. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we're not going to get the Disciple back, which is sad. But yeah, I'm taking the Nemesis Immortals, stick on the green game plan, though it pains me to see Lightning Strike go away. Because if I do end up playing red, I'm going to be so annoyed I don't have that card. Here now, I'm actually willing to take the Horizon Chimera. This makes me want to be. This is a card that I really love, and you can splash for it. I don't really need the Sedge Scorpion per se, and we'll probably get the one or two we want. And the rest of the pack's kind of dorky. Ordeal is fine if we were doing that, but we're not doing that. Horizon Chimera! Ooh, Lake Gary, not doing that. Do I want to center Battlemaster or another time to feed? We don't have a lot of fives, but we're gonna get to fives. We already have a one time to feed and a Feral Invocation to trigger Centaur Battlemaster. If we go red, we have more things to trigger Centaur Battlemaster, and it works really well with Devotion. Yeah, we're gonna take a Centaur Battlemaster. Our fives are stupid. Devotion's nice, and we have a couple of triggers already to make it A-okay. Ooh. We take the Nessian Courser, round out the curve, 3/3s are grand. Shrine Wind is a good sidebar card, Horizon Scholar, great card as well, but we're sticking to green. Slam, slam, slam. Wow, now I'm gonna take the Voyage's End. Since I do kinda wanna play the Horizon Chimera, Voyage's End better than the Titan Strengths. So we're gonna kinda commit to that right now. Don't think the Sealock Monster is gonna play, but it might. Don't need another Vulpine Goliath. Hopefully, you don't have to run the first one. Hello, Sibith Hemlock. How tasty you are. Ooh, okay. Back to some more rough decisions here. If I were to just stay on green blue, I'd take this Agent of Horizons, but Polish Crusher is really powerful. And I don't mind splashing blue or red for either of these cards if I want to be super duper greedy. But I'm already with such weak packs, pretty low on a couple of different cards. Like I only have one Nessian Courser, and in green, I really want this slot filled out. Yeah, this Chimera and the Voyage's End really put me into the blue category. So I'm just gonna be conservative, not take the Polish Crusher. Dissolve's okay, but really, what a waste of a pick. He's just at the point of the pack where it doesn't really matter. Go dissolve. Ooh, yeah, Disciple. One of my Savage Surge eventually too, but this Disciple tabling is exactly what I wanted. And another Nihilia's Disciple, exactly what I wanted. And we are full on in green devotion mode. We're gonna get rid of the Demolish, even though I don't think it really matters. So in that case, we'll just take Commune of the Gods. It's on color. Here, I'll take a Warrior's Lesson over a second Hedonist. I do need more 2-drops, but I'm definitely gonna want to play 2 Hedonists. I'll bait this guy's foil. I might make more Warrior Lessons a game plan if for some reason we end up having more Centaur Battlemasters. Though I highly doubt that's gonna happen. Alright, what stupid cards do we have? A Hedonist, a Warrior's Lesson, a Dissolve. By stupid, I mean cards that don't really fit in with what the deck's trying to do. Sealock Monster, although fine card, but double blue is not where I want to be, though. I mean, we have no bad, third color restrictions right now on our mana base, so not the end of the world. Mnemonic Wall's not doing a whole lot. We only have one Voyage's End. Can't really abuse it. Faerie's Band, Centaur, and Vulpine Goliath are dorky big drops. We'd rather get some Nessian Asps in line. Boon Satyr is a great pickup. Would love a Leaf Crown Dryad as well, but Satyr's awesome. Here's this time to feed I would really like to see. I'd like to get a second time to feed for our removal going on. And after that, Battlewise Hoplite's pretty tasty, but Prussian Chimera could come around. I think I'd rather the Chimera than the Sealock Monster. I'm gonna have plenty of fatties. Sure, the time to feed works great with the Sealock Monster, but green, we're not gonna have a problem firing that off. Really just get some flyers on board. Like to see some Horizon Chimera get passed around. Seeing an Arbor Colossus passed around is great, and another time to feed bodes well, just because if there's a bunch in the pool, then I should really get my second one. I don't know if I want a third, but a second one's cool. Our deck is not doing the ordeal thing. And we're already going major green, so let's beef up the green. Wave Crash Triangle would be fine in the 3-drop slot, but having picked up the Boon Satyr, we have decent threes to stay alive with. But of course, there's no reason not to have an awesome Arbor Colossus. Wingsteed Rider and Annex and Cymeed. Oh, those are super powerful cards. I might just cut them. Do I want a Staunchhearted Warrior? It's not horrible in my deck, considering I already have the Time, Feral, and I'm probably gonna get one or two others. Warrior's Lesson is arguably playable. Let's clean up. I want to remember I have these. Let's just clean up kind of like the wish list of the best cards in our deck right now. Yeah, we do want to fill out the 2-drop with maybe like another Voyaging Satyr or something. I'm not really hurting for a 4-drop, and this Warrior is just so much weaker than these cards. I'm actually okay with just making a power play cut right now. Let me take the Wingsteed Rider away. Versus the Ordeal or anything. Yeah. Ooh, and an Asp? Vaporkin's good too, and we need twos, but it's not really what our game plan's doing, and we still want to stay major green. This guy's way better. The Occult would be nice to have as well, but that's not gonna happen at all. Now we can get rid of the Faerie's Band Centaurs, even though we're still short on playable, so it's not like I want to hide everything I'm not playing. Here I'll take an Hedonist over a Bronze Sable. The only reason the Bronze Sable would be better is because of Intimidate for factors, but if I'm looking just around a 2-drop slot, I want more devotion to green. So this guy's better. And everything else is kind of lame. I don't want a Cosine Chimera in my 4-drop slot. I got better 4s. I'd rather just have more 2-drops. Although an Aqueous Form was going to be very good in the deck. We're going to have a lot of beatdown. And this guy will help us scry into like our Nihilea. And also just help us attack with our big old fatties. Maybe even put it on a Centaur Battlemaster. So that would be very nice. Prescient Chimera, not the one tabling, so that's something to consider. And I'm not too sure if I really want to go double blue in an Arbor Colossus deck. Might even want this Fade into Antiquities instead. But this can come out of sideboard against flyers. Right now, I don't have any of the Shredding Winds that we passed. They didn't come around yet, or they haven't tabled in the draft. People picked him up before they got back to me. Charlatan could actually get there. It just has another 3 drop. It's not gonna be too hard on the mana to play it. Don't care about really anything else. I guess maybe Return Phalanx is really good. I don't have any great instants or sorceries. I have a Voyage's End, which is great, but not really. I don't think the Charlatan's gonna get it done that way. Hey, Shredding Winds, that's good. Something I'm actually excited to have to beef up against Flyers. Another Seelock monster. Might take this presence just to turn on my my Nylea peeps. Could smooth out if I want to play this Chimera or not. I'm definitely taking it over a second Seelock monster, so I don't know why I'm thinking so hard right now. I don't really want another Vulpine Goliath. Don't really care about anything else either. But Goliath might make it. Ooh, the Occult came back? Dang, maybe the Goliath will make it. Doubtful, but still. Please play Yoke Docks. I would love it if people play Yoke Docks. Alright. Fun Nylea's deck. I haven't done a Nylea deck, I think, in this entire draft. I haven't really first picked it. Certainly haven't done this heavy of a green devotion with anything I've done, so this should be pretty okay. Should be pretty okay. Okay, here's our first breakdown with 15 creatures and a couple of other dudes coming along here. Really, really weak sideboard options and a pretty wonky curve. So draft not particularly awesome, but we saw that just from the first pack of how weak it was. I have these Titan Strengths up here to the right as possible inclusions. I could go ahead and pop these guys down. Maybe take out an Aqueous Form. I have like two blue and two red spells in such a heavy green deck. But, I mean, I do have this Nylea's Presence to kind of help with that, so I'm considering it. I still have three cards to put in already from this base. I don't really have any great dudes within that. And actually, yeah, I think that's kind of what I want to do. The Aqueous Form is good, don't get me wrong, helps pound through him with the Scry, but I think the Titan Strength's gonna be a little bit better. And here I can have a pretty solid mana base of 11 green sources, with the Satyr, Occult, and Nylea's Presence to help get to our triple green and ramp and whatnot. And then I get three blue sources and three red sources, as well as an Nylea's Presence and an untappable Void. Even though I only ever need one, I don't really need to do it twice, but should help. Allow me to be greedy, having this presence and just a couple of splash cards in each color. I don't run 18 lands, despite the fact I have a pretty high curve. I think 17 should still be fine. I'm just not too sure if I want to play a Vulpine Goliath here, which is really great for devotion, and you know we're gonna have the means to get to six drops. Or if I want to play the Warrior's Lesson, which doesn't have a whole lot of utility, except for it does help the Centaur Battlemaster. But you know what, since I did put in the two Titan Strengths, I'm not as worried about the Battlemaster, and why not just have an extra devotion to help with our Nylea God of the Hunt, our Disciples, and our Occult. Yeah, I think that's a little bit better. Shredding Winds will be a first slam bring in over the Vulpine Goliath should we see some good flying targets that I want to care about. Yeah. That's the game plan. 2-1? No thanks. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. I think that'll do it pretty nicely. We have a nice, sweet, fun deck. Let's take her to the table.